Consider this fiber optic cable. An optical fiber cable is made up of thin strands of glass or plastic. These strands carry information between two places in the form of light. As you know, glass is a dense medium that refracts light, but light does not refract inside a fiber optic cable. Do you know why the incident ray does not refract here? Well, we can understand the reason for this once we understand the process of total internal reflection. A ray of light passing from a dense medium to a rare medium refracts and bends away from the normal. Here, the angle of refraction is greater than the angle of incidence. When the angle of refraction is equal to 90 degrees, we get a critical angle, denoted by C. In this case, the angle of incidence is equal to the critical angle. But when the angle of incidence becomes greater than the critical angle, then the refracted ray does not enter the rare medium. Rather, it is reflected in the same medium. This is what we call total internal reflection. Going back to the example of the optical fiber, the light ray hits the inside surface of the wall of the optical fiber at an angle greater than the critical angle. Due to this, the light ray reflects within the same medium. Remember, there are two necessary conditions for total internal reflection to happen. One, the ray of light must be traveling from a dense medium to a rare medium. Two, the angle of incidence must be greater than the critical angle. Many optical instruments use the principle of total internal reflection. Let's take a closer look at a few instruments. A prism periscope is an instrument used for viewing objects that are higher or lower than our eye level. Therefore, they are usually used in tanks and submarines to observe movements without being seen. It consists of two prisms that are fitted into each end of the tube. In the periscope, light hits the top prism at an angle of 45 degrees. This is greater than the critical angle of the prism, hence total internal reflection occurs. This reflected ray leaves the top prisms at the same angle. It then strikes the bottom prism at an angle of 45 degrees and is reflected into the viewer's eyes. Hence, the periscope directs the light from the object to the observer. Total internal reflection also occurs in binoculars. A binocular uses two prisms on each side. The critical angle of a prism is around 42 degrees. When light enters a right-angled prism, it creates an angle greater than the critical angle, causing total internal reflection. A mirage is a naturally occurring process in which light rays bend to produce a displaced image of distant objects or the sky. On a hot day, the land heats the layers of air closer to it. However, as we move higher, the layers of air get relatively cooler. Thus, the hot lower layers of air near the ground form rarer mediums and cold upper layers form denser mediums. These layers act like a lens distorting our reality. Thus, the result is a mirage, where the objects appear lower than their actual position. Now, when light coming from sky travels from denser to rarer mediums of air, it bends more and more until it exceeds the critical angle. Beyond this angle, light reflects. This process is called total internal reflection. When this reflected light reaches our eyes trace it backward as a straight line. Hence, the reflection of the blue sky appears on the ground and our brain thinks it is water, thus causing a mirage. Fish eye view. When light travels from water to air, it bends away from the normal at the boundary of water. But when the angle of incidence is greater than 48 degrees, total internal reflection occurs. If you were a fish in a pond, when you looked up, you would see the reflected views of the sides and the bottom of the pond. Light refracts towards the normal when light enters water from air. Because of this, the outside world would appear compressed to you, the fish in the pond. Let us do a quick exercise. Analyze this statement. Take a minute to think and discuss with your friends. On a hot day, the sun heats up the air unevenly. This means we will have numerous layers of air with different temperatures. The layers of air near the ground are hotter than the layers above. Light rays refract while traveling from the cooler rays to the hotter layers. In the layer nearest the ground, total internal reflection occurs. A mirage appears when total internal reflection and refraction happen in these layers. A mirage occurs because of the different densities in each layer of air. The difference is caused by different temperatures. In this video, we learned about total internal reflection and a few of its applications. Total internal reflection occurs when a ray of light travels from a dense medium to a rare medium. Also, the angle of incidence must be greater than the critical angle. Total internal reflection is used in instruments such as fiber optics, binoculars, and periscopes.